There's some weird things on that there, internet.
If y'all like this, then we can always do more of them.
There's actually one game that seemed okay. I'm not sure exactly how meta it is per se, but it's an RPG Maker game, and I saw the art, and the art looks really good.
Mm-hmm.
So why don't we just try this a little bit as a little change of pace for a game that we might actually play for a little bit of time. But it's called Hello Charlotte. Came out like 2015 or something. It has like 3 episodes. This is the first one. But it seems nice. I don't know. My world met its end a long time ago. The humanity, as I knew it, ceased to exist and disappeared without a single trace. The gods they believed in have died, and churches were built on their graves. Or as their graves, I guess. The chaos turned into order, and it finally became quiet. All I can do is dream, for I am so, so tired. Before I abandon the words that form noise in my head, will you be so kind as to join me in dream scene? Junk food, gods, and teddy bears. Hello, Charlotte.
It's nice to meet you. Please take care of me. This is my room.
It's rather minimalistic.
Quite modern, don't you think? Let's go to the dining room. I'm hungry.
Oh, God.
Dear Charlotte, I'll be home late. Call 0800 XXXXXXXXXXXXX to order food from Charlie's. XO. Mom. Aw.
This note is 8 months old.
Oh.
My parents work on holidays.
New task received. Order food.
8 month holiday.
Tableware inside. The house. Basement. Dissection room. Tailoring room. And test rooms. Ground floor. Living rooms.
Oh, yes, the dissection room that every house seems to have.
All right, so you said RPG Maker game that, oh, you know, maybe we'll actually like come back to this. Do you hear this music?
Fine.
Contrarian.
Puppet control menu has 4 options. Stuff, tasks, rewind points, and exit. Junk is stuff we throw away. Stuff is junk we keep.
That's true.
Yeah. Tasks are daily life quests. Rewind points contain save files of previous events. NB should only be used if Puppet dies or if Puppeteer must leave the control console. Exit should not be an option for the responsible Puppeteer. Puppet menu. Oh, yeah, okay. Same thing.
The last time I tried to cook something, the world was almost destroyed by a food monster.
That's a big move.
So she's a scientist.
I wish Bennett didn't put his chemicals on the shelves along with the sugar and salt.
So, not even our dining room drawers have anything edible. Go rewind point. This notebook contains all of the world's secrets. Oh no, we'll leave it for now.
Play Mad Father. It's horror, but it's
TV
not
room.
Scary, more mysterious.
That is, there's no more accurate description for this room.
Watch TV? It's a waste of time. All 99 channels show commercials 24/7. Next on Panopticon TV, Synthmeal commercial, don't miss it. Sure. You and only you can stop the world crisis. Help by stop overproduction by buying things now. No.
It's so noisy. That's enough TV for today. It wasn't locked yesterday.
But no one else is home.
Hey, it's Charlie's Organic Junk Foods. Please place your order.
I'd like to order eco-friendly chicken nuggets and an instant diabetes soda, please. I shouldn't be so nervous when I'm talking to the machine.
Thank you for ordering at Charlie's. Stay healthiest with us.
Oh my god, I thought that was actually our doorbell.
Oh, access denied. Input magic word.
Oh, they're ringing your doorbell still.
Please?
Oh.
What a nice girl. Access granted. Yay.
Oh.
I haven't heard magic word in so long. Ladder leads to the basement.
Gotta answer the door first.
Okay.
strange hissing noises coming from behind the door. Want me to open it?
Yeah.
Charlotte opens the door.
There's a giant cockroach behind it.
Charlie's Healthy Junk Food Delivery, please sign here. Jesus Christ.
Okie dokie. Gotta make my signature beautiful.
Charlotte draws a large X on the paper.
Nailed it.
Thank you. Hope you enjoy the rest of your day. Deliveryman hisses politely and leaves. A lucky meal. Feed Charlotte.
I think that you did feed Charlotte. Oh no.
Fact, chicken nuggets are vegetables too.
Wow, Nyanny, I didn't know you were a vegetarian.
I'm a vegetarian.
You eat chicken nuggets and broccoli.
I do.
Salad every day.
Those things. Every day, sometimes twice a day.
Mm. Hisses politely. Oh.
What a mockery of real food. Is it all they can offer these days?
You should... Oh, is this... You should try wallpapers, my... Oh, yeah, I guess so.
You should try wallpapers, my dear child. They're especially rich in iron.
Oh.
Don't listen to him! Soap is much better in nutrition!
Guys? Do I get a say in this?
I think we're hallucinating.
Aliens
here.
Don't really have a concept of personal space, do they? By the way, Mr. Aiden, the door to the ground floor corridor doesn't open.
Yeah, gas mask bunny ears, right?
It's closed for minor construction works. Nothing to worry about.
If you come out at night, you might find something interesting there.
Aiden pinches Bennett, I say out loud.
Oh!
Stop giving the child weird ideas. Don't listen to him, dear girl.
If you want to join in, I'll be watching SoapNet on TV, in the TV room. Soap operas just call for soap milkshakes.
Bennett leaves.
I almost forgot. Come to the dissection room later. I have a favor to ask of you.
Aiden and Huxley leave too. So, what now?
I want to go to the TV room with our husband.
Okay.
I've decided he's our
soap,
husband.
Soap milkshakes?
Yeah.
Bennett is absorbed in watching TV.
Pick up the remote, maybe? Okay. That's fine.
Sewing for everyone, dressmaking made easy, fancy folds, the art of napkin folding.
Aiden's bookshelf. I find it cute.
Anarchist cookbook, now with more recipes. Kaboom! Advanced chemistry for explosive enthusiasts.
Is that a real book you can buy? I remember hearing about the Anarchist's cookbook a bunch of times, but I thought it... I don't know if it was a real thing or not.
Never heard of it. Science Fiction Almanac, 24th edition.
These are Bennett's shelves. They just scream danger and geek.
That's what I strive for. Danger geek.
Danger geek.
Danger geek. Shelves are full of literature in alien language. I can't read the titles. The Nerd Lord, My Fair Salaryman, Astronaut Commando. This is Mother's Shelf. She loves romance books. Oh, oh no.
Oh, the anarchist.
Oh, the magic word is please.
Yeah. The Anarchist Cookbook was published in 1971 and is a book that contains instructions for the manufacture of explosives, rudimentary telecommunications, freaking devices, and related weapons.
Wow.
Huh.
Huh. That wouldn't really fly today's.
Not really, no.
The Golden Apples of the Sun, Physics of the Impossible, One Hit Man.
My humble bookshelf.
Wait.
Is one it's a knockoff like, of One Punch
Man. Is just One Hit Man. He sometimes, kicks. it looks like he copied it from Wikipedia. You can tell by the little one in brackets. Because it's our, what is it called? A source.
Yeah.
What do they call that? Source material.
To the basement. To the basement.
Oh, right.
Don't we want to go to the basement?
Oh, right. Through here, too.
Yeah, let's go to the basement.
What's 2 + 2?
5.
4, of course.
If you are free to make that statement, then it is correct. You may pass. If you are free to make that statement, it is correct.
Huh.
Thanks. Nothing of interest. Nothing of interest.
The first floor. This ladder leads to the basement. I forgot where I put the basement key.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, this game actually seems a little interesting, doesn't it?
It does.
Maybe our bedroom?
But we couldn't get in there, could we?
The top door?
Oh, the first floor. Oh, maybe.
Yeah, because there's the door up there and the first floor that we need to go to.
Oh, no. I kind of want to try getting it wrong.
What are you trying to do? I don't really know.
Can you prove that? If not, access denied. Let's try the first floor.
This ladder leads to the first floor.
Yeah, I can't go.
We'll go to our bedroom again. Or outside?
Where was our bed? I don't know if I can go outside. I'll try it, though, just in case. No need to go outside right now.
Top door.
Top. Man. Yeah. Current user has restricted access to the teleport Omnicube.
Oh, neat.
Current users restricted access to the data Omnicube. Omnicubes. Omnicubes, short for omnipotent cube, or omnipotent cubes, are multitask devices that allow the transportation, duplication, creation, or disintegration of organic matter and the storage of data. Please do not put liquid soap inside Omnicubes as it might cause unforeseen consequences to happen. Screen store user data and monitor user activity. Absolute rule, screens must not be turned off. Current user Charlotte is expected to follow the absolute rules implicitly. We are not responsible for bodily injury, including dismemberment, mental disturbances, or other harm to the user's well-being caused by infringement of the rules listed above. Please choose a category lead, the current user's observation notes. Charlotte, current user who has yet to complete the educational program. Hey, basement key. Nice. User's log might be useful. Look out for puppeteer symbols. Only the users with X in their names have access to all doors.
Our name is
Charlotte,
but we sign our name with an X.
Right.
What are our friends' names?
Bennett.
Two plus two is four.
Oh.
Sewing tools are inside. Open me.
Open the box?
Yeah, Charlotte opens the box. Suddenly, everything collapses into a singularity!
Oh!
Sudden end destroyed the world in less than a second.
Oh my god, this is so funny. I was just reading the team saying this is actually a pretty popular RPG Maker game, and now it appears.
Fucking rip.
That's pretty funny.
Band-aids, scalpels, notes, tea bags, everything's such a mess.
Did I have to go through the whole thing again.
Oh, I do.
You didn't do a save point.
Is there a save point?
Well, I didn't think a singularity would happen for opening a box.
Well, neither did Pandora, but look at how that worked out.
Oh, I have to eat the food? Have I not eaten the food yet?
No.
I don't know if you've ordered the food.
No.
You haven't even ordered the food.
I don't think I've ordered the food.
I know. Oh, wow.
Uh-oh. Ill-mannered child. Oh, no. Back doesn't go back. Maybe. How do I?
Page? Page?
Ah, escape. Okay.
Oh.
The door, lads. Cockroach incoming.
I was wondering what would happen if you said if you didn't open.
I really like their sprites though.
Mm-hmm. Don't forget to do a save.
Yeah, I will. Apparently, it's just a kind of game where danger's lurking everywhere. I want to see at least one. Oh, what? Oh, no. Is it here?
Huxley.
A surgeon who owns an interdimensional clinic on the second floor. User note, once ordered 30 boxes of duct tape for unknown purposes. Clearly, she was just constructing a bunch of duct tape wallets.
Obviously, like I did in high school.
Oh, no, it's not this. This isn't what I want. No. Hobbies are... Oh, the ground floor's butler. Hobbies include sewing and taxidermy. Okay. Oh, no. Sorry, my bad. Occupation, real name unknown. User note. Bennett is the name on the badge of his hazmat suit. Was it this way? If you're free to make that statement, then it is correct. Did I grab the key?
You have not. Nice. Oh, you have. Okay. Oh, look at that.
Not gonna get me this time. Box. It's filled with fabric. It's filled with fabric. Just gonna check over here first. Oh.
Aiden loves his loves order. Even his mannequins are in place.
Yet another polka dot dress.
Hi, Mr. Aiden. Being a busybody as always.
Hello, dear girl. There's a dress I want you to try on, if you don't mind.
I'd love to.
I put on the dress the tailor made. Oh.
Oh, wow. That's nice.
End of the world. Singularity.
Yeah, the singularity occurs and everybody dies.
Whoa. It's totally rad.
It's called White Spotted Jellyfish Dress. It still needs a few finishing touches. I'll give it to you when it's ready.
That's sweet.
That's nice.
This was nice. This was a good interaction.
This was...
I appreciate
it. It's this,
this
ominous music. Why are they doing this? It feels so sci-fi.
Do-it-yourself heart massage. Everything you wanted to know about string theory but feared to ask. The selfish gene. Bad science. The man who mistook his wife for a hat.
Oh, finally some books I've read.
Craving paper. Embrace your inner pika?
Yeah, I think that's where you like crave eating weird things.
Really?
Yeah.
The Almanac of Official History. Huh. What to do if your daughter brings home your ring? User's log. The Umbrella Man. He appeared out of nowhere when I was a child. When I was in kindergarten or in the library with mom or alone in my room, he was always there, watching me with his yellow eyes from the darkest corner of the room, not uttering a single word. When I tried to tell mother about him, he lifted a finger to his lips, as if not wanting me to speak, so I didn't. In my book of truth, I called him the Observer. As soon as I defined him, the man spoke for the first time. Oh, that name is not so bad, I must say, he remarked. However, wouldn't anyone who watches over you become an observer? I had to agree. Then I'll call... Oh, sorry, this is you, Nanny.
Then I'll call you the Umbrella Man.
Slightly taken aback, the man coughed. Although I would have preferred a more euphonic name, let it stay this way.
What?
It's you.
Is it?
Yeah.
Since then, I gave every new person I met in the house a distinctive name.
The Umbrella Man, too.
When Mom asked who I was talking to, I didn't tell her about the Umbrella Man. Instead, I told a lie.
A sweet little lie.
On the day of my 10th birthday, the doorbell rang in the middle of the night. A masked man wearing a top hat and a black suit was standing behind the door.
Hello, little Charlotte, he said with a smile.
The smile of a man who offers children candies.
Oh.
Mother told me not to talk to strangers, I answered in a determined voice. He let out a sigh.
Hey, Salvation. We're good. I'm no stranger to you. Human memory is so ephemeral, isn't it?
Even if I do know you, you must be a bad guy, I insisted.
Me? Bad? Why so?
I had to come up with something. That's because all villains wear top hats.
Is that damn Gono? Was it was the one with Oddjob? Golden Gun? I think it was Golden Gun.
Gold Member?
I don't know. No, it was not Gold Member. The Gold? James Bond with the Oddjob.
Finger?
Yeah, go on. For that. Oh, and they changed it to Shoe.
Oh, yeah, they changed it to Shoe.
Austin Powers.
Austin Powers, yeah.
Oddjob, I think, yeah.
Oh, is that so? What a silly prejudice, the man commented with a small laugh. Suzu, what about Professor Layton? That series isn't over yet, Suzu. Mm-hmm. Just you wait. Don't let this appearance fool you. With those words, he took off the mask. Sorry.
As I thought, the man was none other than the Umbrella Man himself.
Although I'd love to have a chat with you on your significant day of the year, I have come for another reason.
I tilted my head, curious.
Listen closely, little one. I came to inform you that a puppeteer has been assigned to you since you've reached the age of 10.
Who's that?
They are the representative of the true realm designed specifically to watch over your troublesome species. The one assigned to you is a Seth-type puppeteer. As for their purpose, they are here to guide you, the puppets, through your short lives.
Why would they do that?
You see, little one, free will is fiction.
Mm-hmm. I chewed on my words, trying to come up with a smart reply.
Ah, this choice of words must have been too difficult for a child. Let me put it another way. Meet your new friend who will watch over you. Their name is Seth. Don't bully them too much, okay?
Who's Seth?
Soap Bible. So your son is an alien. How to raise your IQ by watching soap operas.
I'm not sure about the usefulness of the second book.
The Complete Guide to Conquering the Universe, 425th Fail-Proof Edition. Cannibal Man, Set Free. Human Encyclopedia, the Complete Edition. Clinical Surgery for Dummies, 1,000 Human Diseases to Die From.
Huxley is busy dissecting a corpse. Presumably, it was once human. Or it was human once. Hi, Dr. Huxley!
Hello, little Charlotte. About the little talk we had earlier, can you do me a favor of looking after my lovely nephew for a couple days? I've been so busy working on the cure for the eye plague that I can't keep an eye on him at all. For all I know, he could be collecting rare specimens in broad daylight right now. He's too passionate for his own good.
Aren't you too passionate for your own good yourself?
The main reason why I'm worried about him, Hover, is that he has no sense of direction, you see. He may have a bad attitude, but don't let that get to you.
Okay, I'll help.
Felix, come here.
Oh.
I don't need anyone to look after me, Uncle Huxley.
Uncle?
Right. Now go play with your new big sister. Uncle has science to do.
There he goes again. It's nice to meet you, Felix. I'm Charlotte.
Hi. If you want to make it through the day, don't you dare invade my personal space.
Well, I can almost feel his glare burning into my skin. This is gonna be a long day.
New locations in that dissection room are not available. Kill time. How does one kill time? Don't mind me. I'm just gonna pop a quick save.
Oh yeah, singularity. Cause a singularity. That's a good way to kill time.
Wait here.
Literally?
So this is where Bennett's crew works?
Pretty much. Stuff usually blows up in here, so it has restricted access.
His name appears to be Baldwin. I love Baldwin. It's Antoinette.
Marie?
This guy has Archibald written on his suit label. He's Goodwin. This person has no suit label.
Oh.
It's Franklin! Oh. It's Lecter.
Hi, Florence. What's up?
We've discovered that adding dark matter to the dough improves the taste of a chocolate cake by 15%. Don't tell anyone.
Okie dokie.
Found tongue terror. Take it.
Right. Should have known.
This one's fake anyway.
Yeah. Did you take it?
No. I had the option of putting it back or no.
I feel like you should take it.
I can't.
Wait. Now it's... Oh, I see. It's pretty plausible if we take into account all of the conspiracy theories.
Miss, you take it?
No. That's funny.
Shh, they're watching.
I've always considered a possibility of be- I always consider the possibility of being watched. It is pretty plausible if we walk into or take into all account all the conspiracy theories.
They're watching.
Always watching.
Watching you. Oh.
Oh, oh
no.
What's this squishy?
A specimen for research and an organ supply. Look, but do not touch.
Hi, squishy.
You cannot touch.
Psycho pixie, that's nice.
Move aside. The door scans for a boy's eye.
Oh. One door out of three leads to death.
Spooky.
Bleh. Well, I hope you enjoy the Monty Hall room.
Oh, yes. No!
The Monty
Hall room. Oh, boy. Do I know the Monty Hall problem? Open the door and die. Survive and get a prize.
Wow. Is this for real?
You want to check? I'm going to go door number three.
Door number three.
Fuck. Come on.
I wonder if it's random each time. Connection lost.
I didn't even get the chance to switch my answer.
That's not a Monty Hall.
That's Monty Hall at all.
That wasn't Monty Hall at all. If I did it again, that'd be the real Darwin Award.
Oh, yeah.
Door one. Nothing happens. Open another door. Door two. It seems it is random.
Or the prize was nothing happening to you.
You get to continue living. Congratulations. Okay, let's see.
Okay.
Door one. Oh, crap.
Don't you just like want to open door one and then walk through it?
Yeah.
I guess so. I mean, sure. If you're into that. I thought it was only one door out of three explodes, though. I know I have to open another door.
Three. Go three. There. It's an order.
Oh, I got an Azure ribbon.
Oh, nice.
Oh, I'm wearing it now. Was I always wearing that?
No.
Something is added.
That's cute.
Very cute.
Hugs looks very busy.
Yeah.
Open me. No.
Never trust boxes with hearts on them.
Fair.
Oh yeah, we have to do this now.
Still busy, Mr. Aiden?
Hello, little Charlotte and Felix. Since you're here, would you mind trying on some clothing? What a pain.
Charlotte covers Felix's mouth with her hand.
Of course we do.
Charlotte seems like a nice girl.
Yeah.
Too nice.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it wasn't locked yesterday.
Bennett looks sad.
Hi, Bennett.
Are you dead or something?
After 1,037 episodes and 10 specials, they finally confessed their undying love to each other. Underneath my protecting suit, I'm dying from complicated feelings.
Aww.
Let's leave him until he's ready to return to the harsh reality, shall we?
Damn, that would be a payoff and a half.
Yeah.
It's like the original story to How I Met Your Mother.
Looking for the next thing.
Huh. Well, Big Sis is going to sleep. How about you?
I do not require sleep. I'll grab a bottle of soap and measure your brain waves while you sleep, stupid human.
Sounds like a plan. I suppose I don't have to accompany you to the bathroom.
No way in hell. Go to sleep already.
Good night.
Oh, that's pretty swell.
Well, I'm off to bed.
Gonna measure your brain waves. Sounds like a plan.
Okie dokie, love.
She's been surrounded by this but for her whole life. She was 10.
Oh, something slimy crawls into the room.
No!
Hide! Hide! Charlotte hides under the bed sheets.
Oh, hey, Mudcat. You scared my puppeteer a little.
That's funny.
My cat turned into a maggot. Or was he a maggot all along that turned into a cat?
The mad cat states, as it makes itself uncomfortable on my bed. Oh.
Good night, cat.
That's kind of cute.
Very cute.
Charlotte pets the mad cat. It purrs. Charlotte falls asleep peacefully.
This has been quite a game. Oh no.
What is that sound? Felix promised to come back soon too. Did he get lost in the house? How about we go look for him?
Consider taking pepper spray.
Mm-hmm. A flamethrower would be more effective, don't you think?
Can't argue with that.
Yeah. I got that hunger in me though.
Yeah. Yeah. I just gotta see what's right around the corner though. It could be anything.
Could be anything.
I bet you it's in here.
Oh.
Wait.
This door has been locked the whole time. Oh, you're going to go
into the
TV. Cover
glass missing, go in?
Felix couldn't have gone here, could he? What is this place? I don't remember our house having a direct passage to a princess castle. It's too dark to see anything.
There was a book back there on that. There.
You will find what you need upstairs.
You gonna ignore the other doors? What are you doing? What is your plan right now?
I don't know. What I need is upstairs.
Again, go!
I just figured I'd go.
It's from the. I'm just always blown away because you. Oh.
Oh, what? Why did I just get shot to death?
That's funny.
Is that what I needed? Was this the one that was locked though? This was the one. Oh,
yeah,
this
it's been
was
locked the whole time.
It's so weird that we went left and then came out right.
Yeah.
Though.
I don't know why they did that.
Freaking shot to death. Why?
Because life can end that easily. And didn't you get taught the Monty Hall problem? Oh, what you need is a big shot in the face. I see.
It's raining in here.
It's just a yellow teddy bear. Nothing scary at all.
The ultimate guide to skinning and gutting. Homo sapiens cooking with passion. What else could happen?
Ah! Bear.
Human taxidermy. Going wild. Hunting. Human rights. 8 contested meanings of nature.
Bear is still moving.
Now this seems creepy.
Ah!
Little teddy bear wants to play. Oh my god. You're actually... Oh. Okay.
Wow. So this game actually gets kind of gross.
Yeah.
Seems like it.
Did anyone ever make one of these RPG Maker games that wasn't just horrible?
You mean like I mean I think this is pretty okay. Like
I mean
overall.
Like without any sort of terrible aspect to it.
Not a good one. I actually have a different RPG Maker game that's on the completely different end of the spectrum.
Like it's happy?
Maybe, probably. It should be. I think so. It's raining, it's pouring, the old bear is growling.
It didn't do anything.
What about To the Moon?
Oh, I forgot about To the Moon being a good game that nothing bad happened in. Oh, there's a hole in the wall, don't...
Crack in the wall, a little growl is coming from it.
Fine.
Rain, go away, Teddy, little Teddy wants... So funny though, he just... Oh god, no! I didn't think he'd fall. Oh god, he's so fast!
The faster you move, the faster he got.
Holy shit!
That was not nice.
So bad.
I didn't expect that at all. I thought I'd be able to like run to the door. Pixels are scary, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's fucking... So I don't know how we don't die there.
Go into the other room and pull the thing.
Sorry, Will. end it soon. I just wanted to get this as one.
How soon
thing.
Is soon?
3 minutes.
Okay.
Oh, go into the room, pull the thing, and try to run to the other room.
Wait, what? This one?
No.
Yeah.
Start in the...
Oh!
Yeah, and then run to the...
Other room.
So go in here.
Yeah, pull the thing, get out of
there. Now. Pull the thing and then go to the left room?
Yeah. Because the speed was...
The room. Oh, hi, Mark.
Okay, now...
Now go?
Leave?
I pulled it.
Yeah, I guess.
Bear on? Bear off. I guess it bared off. Should we go for this door now?
Door?
Yeah. Yeah. Damn it! What do they want you to do?
Secret passage?
Maybe the bear doesn't chase us anymore.
Yeah.
Go back in here?
Yeah.
Oh, nice! It's like Ratatouille, but with a little teddy bear.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's... Oh,
back door key. Some vegetables.
I hope the bear doesn't come back. I can't bear this game. It's unbearable.
Oh.
I don't think it's
shot
a friend.
To death.
Oh! The little girl's eyes well up with tears at the sight of Charlotte.
I'm very sorry. Can I help you somehow? Are you lost?
Aren't you lost yourself, big sister?
That hurt.
Lee, Freya doesn't talk to strangers. Midnight's Book Club, Bear Clubs.
What's that waffle on the wall there?
Flower.
Oh.
Lovely honey.
Oh god, no!
Rabbit toys, take one?
Yeah. Oh, why do you need another one or don't? I think they're the same.
Hush, it's cute. I got it.
Mm-mm.
Oh, God.
The bear.
Oh, I wonder if I can give it to that girl.
Yeah.
The girl sightlighted at the side of the rabbit toy.
Want me to give it to you?
I can have it?
Sure. Here you go.
Thank you.
Bang.
Your eyes look like egg whites. I think that's a compliment, I guess?
No. Hold on a sec.
Whoa. Oh, you should.
I think you just go.
I'm looking for a little boy. He must have lost his way in this place, too. Have you seen him by chance? No, there's no one but Freya. I see. You must be very lonely. Freya's finding her anyway. Get lost already if you're not going to stay.
The other door.
The other right. door, yeah.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
The cat room. Don't look in the mirror, okay? Take a break. Yo,
saved.
That music, though. The bear room. I hope there aren't any actual bears in there.
You haven't saved in a while. There you go.
Don't
right
the
up
mirror.
The middle? Oh. Oh.
The cat room. Hello, kitty. Don't drink from the right cup, okay? Don't drink from the left cup. Wait.
Oh, wait, no.
Wait, but
no,
they're reversed.
It's fine. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because it's... That cat's left, and that cat's right.
Yeah, so you drink from that cup.
This one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wait, what?
What?
Enter the right fireplace. Cats do not tell lies.
Yeah, like I beat him.
No, that huge spider is not in the wall anymore.
Probably the best.
No, no, it's gone.
Yeah. Awesome.
I can't. Okay, oh, drink me. Drink. I feel dizzy. And then enter the right fireplace, it said? Flames are dancing, fireplace. Go inside.
Oh, yeah, okay, go.
Oh no! It said the right fireplace was fine.
It's right fireplace, I bet.
No, the correct fireplace is fine.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Surprised how many ways to die and...
Oh, they fit all into these this, right?
Ways to die have... I feel dizzy. So...
Just go... Yeah.
Enter the right fireplace.
Which is to the bookshelf facing outwards, this one.
Okay. The fire embraces... Damn it! Well,
just don't go into fireplaces is the answer.
Maybe it's the right fireplace after we put it out. I don't know.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense. Gotta put it out first.
I like how that little, like, white room basically kind of, like, taught you how the game worked.
Mm.
Sometimes you're gonna go through doors. Some of those doors will kill you.
Yeah.
Don't drink from the right cup. I drank from a cup already. Cats do not tell lies. Don't drink from the left cup. I guess I'm just not going to go in the fireplace right now. I'm just not. Not until something changes.
That's a fair enough assessment of the situation.
I need to find a key. The door is closed. Don't look in mirrors either. Nothing of interest here.
The bear room.
Teddy's glare at me from the shelves. It's
angry
dark outside the window.
Room.
White flowers are my favorite.
Oh, I don't like that bear.
25th edition of the Sci-Fi Almanac. Can we take it, please? You can take it.
High five for a fellow nerd.
You high five with Charlotte. Aw. Throw a second move any second. There's a key in the napkin. Nice.
Frick, that bear's going to come and get us.
No, it won't. We're fine, Danny.
Okay.
The door doesn't open. What? Oh, no! Damn it. Yanny, why? Why'd you say that?
Because I know.
Why'd you say that? Why would you say that?
The bear!
Well, no matter. Was that the good demo we wanted to get?
Okay. I don't know. Do you guys want to finish this someday? Or are we just going to leave this forever and never finish again?
Yeah, tell us what you want.